again today in the face of a little try.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Fishing Off the Hook. And today, first off, I'm going to start off with, I have a new shirt on today. This one is my new fishing shirt, Will's Sport and Tackle. So check them out. I think they have a website, willsportandtackle.com. So check them out. We're going to do a little comparison test today. Can you show right here? It's going to be this guy. It's a Renosky right there. Renosky Sonic Swang Minnow. It's an unknown brand. I've never seen it before, actually. But it was only $150 at Walmart. So I decided to pick this one up along with a leading brand, the Mepps Comet Minnow.
Now
this one, just to start off, is a lot heavier, so it will cast farther, I can guarantee that.
And it's a lot more expensive.
Yeah,
so
this one was about $550.
Yeah.
So
we'll find out.
What we're going to do today is compare the well-known brand, I'm sure you've probably all heard of Mepps before, they've been around a while, and versus the unknown brand, the Renosky, or whatever it is, Renosky Lures. So we're gonna check it out and see how it works today. Out there. We are here at the lake, folks. We're about to cast out. Look at that. Beautiful day. Well, there you go, folks. First catch of the day, but it wasn't a trout. It was a little yellow perch. Actually, he's fat for a perch. Check him out, right? See on the camera? Nice. Look at him. Look at that guy. First catch on the Renoskys. We're gonna keep count. There he goes. Nice. Well, that's good. Let's get a little fishy. That's probably the biggest perch I've ever caught. Biggest yellow perch I've ever caught. Oh! Do we have a fish? Oh. He might have had a hit. Maybe he hit the side of him. Alright, so what we have here is hits just about every cast. And I think they're the perch, actually, so. That explains why Ryan can't get one in, because his lure is actually a little bit bigger, his hook is bigger. Yeah. But what we did was, Ryan's goes deeper, it's heavier. He's got the Mepps on there, so it's a thickie. So it goes deeper, so what I'm doing is letting it sink a little longer. And I'm getting to the right spot. See if I can get another hit. Guess what? I got another fish. Check it out. It's a trout. He's a little trout. Look, he's a skinny trout. Off he goes. So Ryan keeps getting hits over there on his, but he's missing them for some reason. That's happened a lot. I can't figure it out. I think it might be a design thing. What we have in difference in design here is this one, the hook is hanging off the bottom of him like that. It's kind of detached. But Ryan's, the hook is on the tail. You saw it. It's like attached to this part. So it's like embedded in the little minnow. So I don't know, it might be a design thing. Maybe it doesn't hook fish unless they have big mouths. It's very possible. All right, well, we're heading back. We didn't get to stay too long today, so that's why we kinda just only caught a couple of fish, but it was a good little lure test. We got, Mepps did not end up getting any fish like I thought it did, but we'll probably use them again sometime. Maybe we can do another comparison test in the future, but for now, I have to say that this Renosky lure, the Minnow, Sonic Minnow, is a great little lure. Pick one up for $150 at Walmart right there. So anyway, thanks for watching the show today, and we'll see you next time on Fishing Off the Hook.